just go of the best game that there is, or like the best game just for the sake of how good it is, I would take this game. But not of in a realistic way, you know. In a realistic way, if there's only one thing that I could take on an island and I would be able to somehow survive and stuff, but and I could somehow play a game, like I would take the game with the most replay value and something that has online connection, because that would just make the most sense. So let's do some world record attempts. My cat just shit. Nah, she didn't. I don't know for how much longer I will be streaming. Yes. That's a good start. I'm just kind of tired a little bit after talking for so long. Continue this just because why not? I just feel like it. Let's just continue this for corrected. Actually, why not? Maybe this is another no reset run. I haven't like reset it once, so this would classify as one. Like when I say I want to do no reset runs for a good like life split, that I'm not talking like about no reset runs that I like have to reset like 10 times for to continue it. When I say like no reset run, I mean no reset run, and this would still kind of classify under it. Because like I haven't reset it once for it. So yeah. Like it would classify it as one. Kind of weird how I don't get them. I feel like I play really good and my hands are really warmed up, but but for some reason I don't get those markings. Maybe my rate of pressing A is differently. Like the first try there didn't even surprise me that I didn't get it, but like the other tries that I had on those kind of surprised me. This run I probably won't talk as much though, because like I kind of lost all my energy. Like it's not that easy to like talk for straight out while doing another task. We got a reverse 9-11 split on some of best. My cat is just chilling in the box, man. He's just chilling, man. Too soon.
My cat is doing weird things right now.
There's one cat, oh, she wants to go outside. One second.
So there I am.
Like letting the cat out percent. Thank you. actually think that I don't give this stage enough credibility, like enough credit for its difficulty. Like I think of like 212 as a very easy stage, but in reality it doesn't, it's not actually as easy as I think it is. Like it's very simple in a sense, but there is a huge room to mess up, and it's not about timing. And I know that, but every time I do a mistake in that stage, I feel like I've done something very stupid. But that stage is actually not as easy as I think it is, or as I make it out to be. There's actually like it's a lot about timing on that stage. And depending on certain RNG that you get on that stage, it can become very weird and unusual to execute. So, there is that. Here, please. I knew that could happen, but I went for it anyway. That's kind of sad. Like, I basically gambled there. Like, he could have either went to left or right, and he decided to go to the right. Like, if I would have done it safe, it would have lost a little bit of time, and because I did it so good, I wanted to get like all the times that save that was possible there. So, kind of, you could say I could greedy and try to gamble there for a bit, like it was a 50-50. But, yeah, it doesn't really matter that much. It is just a chill no reset, like the second of the day. I actually plan on doing world record attempts instead of doing a reset attempts, but it turned out to be this way. That felt slow, but I like for some reason like this stage feels slower than it is. Like don't get me wrong, like what I mean by this is this stage used to feel like a bit different, and I don't know what has changed. Like the way the stage feels so different from what it used to feel like, even though I do it the exact same way. Like, just like the in terms of timing of those like platforms, like it's kind of like weird. Like it's like slightly different timing as I remember it, and I haven't really changed anything that would affect it. into my pants. You know, okay, I don't know if you know this feeling. One second, I have to press. But like sometimes, like the pants are getting too high, and then that feels like you're getting choked on your belly. And if you're into that, that's all good and stuff. But I'm not really into that. I'm like against that. That's like, you know, it's like the worst kind of feeling there is in this world. Like, I would rather like I don't know, like take a cigarette and burn my skin with it than experience that feeling for a day. Okay, this sucks. I handled it good though. Was the first death in this run. That was just bad play. They spaced out. Second death. This stage is not easy. It is what it is, basically. The stage is really not that easy. It's kind of common sense that the video in the upper left corner is my world record, or like my PB. But I kind of wanna make it so that even people who like have no idea of speedrunning can understand what it is. Like, I mean, it's very common sense, but like I just wanna have something there that tells this is my world record, or something like that. But I don't wanna make it so that it is all, like ugly and stuff. This is something that I always like look for when I do like my kind of like layout. It's like it has to look good, and if it doesn't look good, it's shit. And if it's shit, I hate it. And if I hate it, I don't generally do it. And if I don't generally do it, it probably means that I hate it. Or that I'm lazy. You have to imagine me being like on drugs right now, even though I'm not technically on drugs. But this is how I imagine being on drugs. Feels like I'm just like very like calm. Okay, it depends. I don't think like it depends what kind of drugs, I guess. But like I'm just like I'm just like so calm, I don't know why. Oh, good RNG. just basically chilling. My mind is at peace. That sounds very religious, but trust me, I'm not religious. Execute this ride. That was unfortunate, I guess. I wouldn't say that it was bad play. I mean, it kinda was, it kinda wasn't. Let's just say you can't be too harsh to me of not reacting to that. But that doesn't mean that shouldn't be changed in the future. But it's something that, wait, why do I have 10 viewers? Like, I just looked to the left and suddenly I have 10 viewers. Then there must be something wrong. Is that the case if I currently have 10 viewers? I appreciate that. I hope you enjoy what you're seeing. I'm kind of like chilling a little bit. So, I'm just like a little bit chilling. Doing a no reset now of Donkey Kong 94. I just did a mistake there. Let's just pretend that it was all according to plan, you know. So now it's back to 3 viewers. That makes much more sense. Started to get nervous. People are watching me. Like, what's wrong with that? And now it's back to 20 viewers. Well, I just like accept it, I guess. Either the viewer count is buggy, or I'm suddenly famous. 20 viewers is not famous, but like, it's much more than I usually would get. So, welcome. Let's hope I get a gold split here on World 5. There is one new strat that I do here, which saves half a second in this stage in particular. If I get out, it's kind of difficult. I lost a little bit of time there. But that doesn't really affect if I get the gold split or not. So let's see if I do or not. Hope the audio is good, by the way. I haven't tested it really. So good RNG here that makes kind of up for the bad play in the other stage. So that was really good. So the next stage is kind of difficult, but it's not really difficult. It's more like getting it an optimal time there is kind of hard to achieve because it's kind of RNG. See what I mean? Like, this jump is not really, you can't always get it consistently, so I lost a lot of time there, like 6 seconds from the optimal outcome. But But it is what it is. At least I got this threat. This is really difficult threat. So this run stays the way it is, or at least gets better, not worse. I want to get a good no reset run. It's actually a lot of things that I like. World 5 is always the most important world for me, because there's always time that I can save over my PB. Like, it's really hard to get a good World 5. And not only because of hard execution, also because like it's a lot of RNG dependent as well, and like hard execution too, like I just said. So in the upper left corner you can basically see my world record. There's no way that I can beat that time with this run. Like I said, this is a no reset run, which means that I just finish the run regardless of what happens. It's what you would see, for example, on a marathon where a person just runs the game and doesn't really reset, just to show off the game. I'm doing this mainly to have like more runs finished with these splits that I'm using. I recently changed my splits, so I haven't really have that many finished runs with these splits. Like you can see, 3 out of 8,607 attempts basically. But like, I have much more runs finished than just 3, but there are only 3 finished runs on these kind of on these splits. So I mainly do it out of that, and also for other reasons too, like for example from practice. So in my PB, or like world record, however you wanna call it, like I refer to it as a PB, but it's technically, it is definitely a world record, but I always refer to it as a PB, because it is for me. I lost 20 seconds on the next stage, which was very unfortunate, because it wasn't really that big of a mistake. Like it was like a small mistake that turned out to be a big one, and it was more of an accident that rather than something that I did wrong. It was just something that can happen. You could even say it was due to the controller, because it might have been due to the controller. This is a big mistake. So something similar to that happened also in my PB. Like, to be fair, the stage is not easy, but at my skill level that shouldn't be happening that often. So I have to get back onto the grind of practicing that stage more, because I start to like kind of slack on that stage quite often. Like I even lost more time stage than in my PB, which shouldn't be a thing ever. And that should also never happen. Like, I tried to cut it too close there, so I collected that other item that I don't need, which lost me like a few seconds. So this overall wasn't a good World 5, but can't always have a good World 5. Or like, you can't always play top. This should never happen too. That was just like, I'm not happy with this World 5. will be losing a lot of time. I actually don't lose as much time as I should lose. The reason why I should lose more time is because it's actually kind of sad that I don't lose more time to the mistakes that I've done in this run. Like, I almost even saved time over my PB, which just makes me want to, like, hate my PB, basically. Like, World 5 wasn't really that good. Like, there were two big mistakes in my PB, which are World 5. Like, I lost 20 seconds to, like, 5-9, and World 8, I lost 25 seconds. Those were the biggest mistakes. So I can improve the PB, but it's still, like, this game is really optimized, and getting a run with all these time saves is not really that easy, but I will get it in the future, that's for sure. Maybe tomorrow. Today, probably not, because I plan on making this my last run for the day. So, today, probably I won't. But it would be boring, right? No, actually, like, I'm lying. It wouldn't be boring if I would make, would get my goal time tomorrow today. Like, I would be fucking hype as shit. Like, I would run naked around the streets and, like, I don't know, scream. Like, I wouldn't care, man. Triggers kind of probably hear an echo for a second. Just tested something. Got the double tumble. Well, this wasn't the way it was supposed to be going. lost some time there because I couldn't get into the fucking hole, man. Wait, what the fuck? Why did my bitrate just go up to 3K? Like, what the fuck? I didn't do anything. Okay, I don't have the options set to like a 3K bitrate, but it suddenly spiked to 3K for like 5 seconds. And then it went back to normal. It was weird. Lost time entering on that door. It was stupid as fuck. Like, I start to not pay attention anymore. Like, I lost a little bit of focus. I start to lose a little bit of focus. This is why this is going to be my last run of the day, probably. Like, most likely. Like, I'm like almost 100% certain. Like, I'm 100% certain. There has to be like my mood has to drastically change for that to not be the last round, and I can I can guarantee that it won't be the case. Nice, that's how it's supposed to. That is a really big mistake. Like, there was, I pressed A, but he didn't jump, so it kind of sucked. Like, I actually did this stage quite amazing, like amazingly well, but like there was something going wrong, you could say. Like, I pressed A, I'm 100% sure. Like, I either pressed it, like, either my A button didn't register, or like there was like a lag frame or something like that. That's unfortunate. So the whole section kind of was unfortunate. Up there. easily die here if you don't get the wall kick like a very fast. That was very unfortunate. I'm thinking if I should go to sleep after this run or if I should do something else. Like, I probably would chill on my bed a little bit to like just watch something. But like, I'm thinking, like, what else could I do after this? Like, there's not much that I'm interested in doing afterwards. We don't really go outside that much.
Or like, I could.
Like, I want to, but I don't know what to do. So, that's kind of my problem. It's more, not that I don't want to go outside, I just don't know what to do outside. Like, I have friends and stuff, but most of my friends don't really. Either they're busy or they're not going outside on the weekends. Oh fuck, man. That was stupid. Like, I'm kind of like losing a lot of focus. Like, I'm just like kind of like. Like, kind of like just really. I'm not paying that much attention anymore. Like, I usually don't do like two full runs in a row. Like, I'm not used to that anymore. So it's not too crazy to losing a lot of time on this bit. Like, this one was going really good for no reason, but it's starting to get not rust. Like, I lost like 2 minutes, I think. But this was good practice today, man. This was really good practice. Didn't expect to do 2 no reset runs today. I thought I would only do 1. I actually planned to not do any one, not play this game today. So for that, doing more than I normally do on average is kind of good. That hurts, like, more time loss. I hope World 8 is going to be good. Like, I'm doing really stupid mistakes that I shouldn't be doing. Like, I'm really throwing this run into the garbage can. Like, this run overall was pretty good for a no reset run. Like, of course there were some mess ups that shouldn't be a thing. But for a no reset run, this was pretty good. But it's really just, like, the run really just said, nah. Garbage can. I mean, let's just get a really good World 8. Like, here, see, you can look at the run, like 9 seconds, 18 seconds, 13 seconds, and then just like I lost like almost two minutes on my PB in, like, I lost 2 minutes on my PB. Like, I lost definitely two minutes in World 7. So I'm gonna and destroy this world. Good RNG here. No, it isn't. Good RNG would mean that I could go for a strat to save even more time. Like, have to gather some energy, man, for this last little bit of run. Like, it's like so draining me. Like, it's draining me, like, literally. Like, doing sometimes like these run attempts or like these runs can be very draining. I have to practice this stage, by the way, again. Like, I'm kind of doing it wrong. That was really good. Today was actually kind of a productive day. Even though it didn't feel like it at all at first. Good RNG, please. It might not be. It can be, it cannot be. Like, it can be, but it doesn't have to be. I thought that. Like, it can still be average RNG. Yeah, average RNG. Like, ever getting average RNG here, like, this could, like, I could classify this as good RNG. Because it is better than average what you get on the stage. And it's a result that is almost the best that you can get. Like, the best is 180 and I got 176. Like, this is a really good time to get there. Like, if you wouldn't have not switched the switch there, I would have been more likely to get perfect RNG and I would have probably got it. But he didn't, so it made it less likely for perfect RNG, but like average RNG was still a thing. Or like good RNG was still a thing. Like, the not perfect RNG was still a thing. So here I can save a lot of time over my PB. Actually not that much. Like, my old PB had like a terrible stage. But my newest one doesn't have a terrible one. But also not a perfect one like this. Like, this was perfectly executed. Like, this saved just like 7 seconds over my current PB on this stage. Like, there's no way that I'm gonna PB or anything, but just like comparing my PBs against it and stuff is always cool. I don't know if this can gold or not. It might not be. And maybe it's able, maybe it's not. Let's just say it like that. It's very like World 8 is like one of the few worlds where there is like a lot of time save. Like, World 8 is like kind of. You lose time everywhere, like small time you lose everywhere basically. Or not everywhere, but like usually you can save a bunch of time in World 8 or lose a bunch of time. Like, possible time save 30 seconds on this world compared to my PB. And that's not even like all the talent you can theoretically save. Like if I do everything perfectly, like I'd probably save like 40 seconds. It's going to be hard. Please work. Yes. I used to. I usually use the grip for those waterfalls where I can press like a which like I, when I talk about a different grip, I'm talking like how I hold the controller, and I usually hold the controller in a way that I can press A really fast. But I kind of forgot to do that there, and it was a stupid time loss. You should never lose time on the stage, by the way. So that was kind of stupid, but this world, besides, it was pretty solid. So let's do this stage optimally. I lost a lot of time in my PB on the stage. I still have all my use of that. Okay, I messed it up. But it's a very hard stage, so it is what it is. At least this is not like, oh, what am I doing? We have a problem, man. Please give me this wall kick. Almost. Well, all the time that we previously saved on this world is gone. Like, I got kind of confused there with normal and then hard strat. So I guess let's just take this as a learning opportunity for the stage. To be fair, this stage is really hard. It's not something stupid where I lost time. It is pretty difficult to do. Like, losing time on this stage, for example, would be dumb. Like, this stage looks really difficult, but when you know what to do, that stage is really simple. Like, everything is so... Like, I just wanna be done with this run. Like, I'm so tired. So fucking tired. Second try, first try. Well, when I say second try, first try, I mean like the other no reset run, I also got it first try, so that's really good. Maybe I can jump over the enemy if I can't. Like, theoretically, it's possible, but in that situation, it's better to just make it safe because he was at this place where it's. It's very hard to jump over him, and it's more likely for you to not get that. You know what I'm saying? So it was better for me to not go for that small time save. Only like when it looks good, I go for it. And on a good run, even when it looks good, I might not even go for it because it's not safe. I got a leg frame. What happened there? I basically gonna lag frame. Most likely, I can't say for certain, because I'm not too familiar with like specifics about games and stuff like. When I say it, I mean like. Don't wanna say things I don't really understand, like, but I'm fair, like I'm 90% certain that it was lag frame. Like what I mean, for example, is that there are a lot of speedrunners out there who will say like that something is frame perfect, and they don't really know for sure if it's frame perfect or not, but they just say it to make it so, or like to indicate that the trigger's hard. But actually, like a lot of times when people say that something is frame perfect to make the trick, to indicate that the trick is hard, they actually make it so that every trick is kind of the same, because every trick is frame perfect, so if everything is frame perfect, nothing is frame perfect, kind of like. And I actually think that those people, like, it's, I hate when people say that something is frame perfect, but we're not being 100% certain if it is or not. That's why I don't usually like to say, like, things are things that I don't like. I don't usually like to say that some things are things that I don't 100% understand. And when it comes to lag frames, I don't 100% understand lag frames, but I can almost guarantee that it was a lag frame. So, you know what I'm kind of trying to say. What I like, the thing, what I hate when people say that something is frame perfect, like even if it is frame perfect, a lot of the times, if there's a person who has actually some clue about it, they actually make it so that the trick is less impressive than it actually is. I'm not 100% sure what that was to say though. Because like a lot of the times there is just more to a trick than it just being frame perfect. For example, there are like, I mean, I don't know this for certain, but like this is like, I would say that there are just a very few frame perfect tricks in Donkey Kong, but there are other things that make this, make a certain trick harder than others. Like, it's just very, like, just very simple to understand, you know? Like, there's more than just, like, the window in which you can execute a trick. Like, you know? For example, I can't really give a good example at the moment. But Donkey Kong 94 would be a good example for it, I can guarantee you this. Because there are, like, not really, like, there might be some frame perfect tricks that are frame perfect that I'm not aware of that there are. Because, like I said, I understand what a frame perfect trick is. Like, it's not like I don't understand what a frame perfect trick is, but, like, I haven't checked if it's actually a frame perfect trick or not. So I would just go off by the perception that it is. So it, there might be some frame perfect tricks that I do that I'm unaware of, just because I just haven't tested it if it is frame perfect or not. But what I can tell is that, like, I just forgot what I wanted to even say. It's just, I don't know, I usually don't like when people, for example, marathon runs, constantly say that something is frame perfect to indicate that it's hard. Like, if they have checked it and stuff, then, I mean, it's fine. I mean, if they want to, like, it's fine. I'm not there to say them how to do a run, but I could imagine it being very cringy for the person who is like a tester or something, or like a person like who looks into the game code of the game, to constantly hear that and just cringe at how wrong it is what that person is saying. Or if that game person has knowledge about that game, you know what I'm saying? Like, imagine that's something that a lot of testers might experience, but not even Royce. Or maybe the Royce, then they're just not. There's just so much more than just the frame trick to be frame perfect. I guess I get remember what I wanted to say. Actually, I don't really 100% remember what I wanted to say. You see that I'm kind of tired. I kinda have to figure out why my roll kicks are not that consistent at the moment. This might seem like an odd thing to say, but I feel like I press like the A button like in a good way. Like I mash really fast, I should get them more often than I do, and then I get them. So I like kinda have to test to why I don't get them more consistently than I should. Was really good play. That was really good play. Like maybe it's something with the controller, but like the A button hasn't really failed me, so I doubt that it is a controller. I mean, I guess it failed me once. Or like actually it failed me twice. And but I still doubt that it is a controller. I don't always want to blame things on controller. Well, that stage was like I executed it. It was really well. So I am unsure whether it is a controller or not. Like, I feel like I should get certain roll kicks more often. Like I have recently switched the controller, so. Might be the controller.